holiday cooking. This is our Thanksgiving edition. So this is where I teach a little bit of cooking, a little bit of history. So y'all remember our last lesson we had for Oktoberfest? What did we make for Oktoberfest?
Pretzels.
Pretzels. Okay. Awesome. Remember a little bit of history about pretzels?
Yes.
Created 610 AD.
All right. Who created them?
Italian monk.
Italian monk. Very good. Very good. And what did the pretzel, the shape of pretzel, represent?
A praying child.
Oh, you guys are awesome. I'm glad you remembered everything. So. All right. So today we are going to talk about Thanksgiving, and we're going to talk about one of my favorite things, stuffing. Okay. So today we're going to talk about, I'm going to give you a little bit of history about stuffing, and then I'm going to describe the key components of stuffing, and then finally I'm going to do a demonstration. I'm going to make my favorite sauce of stuffing, and then after we do that, I'm going to give you guys a chance to develop your own stuffing. So I'm going to give you a list of ingredients, you're going to pick those ingredients and create your own stuffing, okay? All right, so to get started, all right, since you're so good with pretzel history, does anybody know when stuffing was actually first invented?
Medieval times?
Medieval times? A little bit sooner than that. Any other guesses?
Renaissance?
Renaissance? A little bit before that. So, Ethan, do you have a guess?
Biblical times?
Biblical times? Yep, very good. So, it actually traces back to Roman times. So, this is the first written history of stuffing, or mention of stuffing. So, there's actually a chef named Apicus, and he actually wrote a cookbook. So, in this cookbook, he actually had some examples where he had stuffed chicken, pigs, and mice. I don't think I want any mice. So, and also pigs. But. All right, so fast forward to the United States. When do you think the first mention of stuffing was in the United States? Think of what holiday you celebrate where you hear a lot about stuffing.
Thanksgiving. Turkey Day.
Turkey Day. Thanksgiving. Very good. Very
so,
good.
Is the feast the first Thanksgiving?
So the first mention of stuffing was actually in 1836. That's the first time it was written down somewhere that they actually had stuffing in the meal. But it was at Thanksgiving meal. So that's why we eat stuffing at Thanksgiving, traditionally. So now, when do you think the biggest popularity of stuffing was in the United States? Think of something that happened that would be the neatest thing that really created a lot of popularity. Stovetop.
Oh, stovetop.
Instant stuffing.
Oh, instant stuffing.
1970s.
Oh.
That's when stuffing really, really became popular in the United States. So. But we're not making stovetop today. We're going to make the real thing. So. All right. So I keep saying the word stuffing. Have you ever heard of dressing?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's the difference between stuffing and dressing?
Dressing is like a liquid.
And you put it on top.
That's not salad dressing.
Oh! No, it's dressing.
Oh, no.
My guess is?
Don't you not put dressing inside?
Close, yeah. So basically stuffing would be what you put inside of a bird or whatever you're going to stuff. Dressing would be on the outside that you serve separate. So you cook it separate from the bird. So always remember when you're doing stuffing though, don't overstuff the bird. Make sure you wash your hands when you touch the turkey and touch the stuffing. You know, you don't want to intertwine that. So, and then if you're making dressing versus stuffing, you want to make sure you add a little bit more liquid to the dressing because it's going to be outside the bird. It's going to dry out a little quicker. When you put it inside the bird, it has a little bit more juice in there. Okay? All right, so let's talk about some of the key components of dressing or stuffing. I'll say it back and forth. So, first thing, you always want to have bread. Now, you can go ahead and use a good old loaf of bread, cut in cubes. That's a lot of work. So nowadays, they got these nice little bags and stuff that come in little cubes already cut up for you and dried. So this is just regular bread. This is actually cornbread. I like to put some cornbread in my stuff. It tastes a lot better. So in some cultures, they don't use bread. They might use rice. Or actually, some cultures actually use quinoa. So, or tofu as their main ingredient. So another thing you want to use after we talk about the bread component, we're going to look at some veggies. So, what are some examples of veggies that you find stuffing?
Mushrooms.
Onions.
Celery.
Peppers. Good. Peppers. So, just about any kind of vegetable would be good to put in stuffing. So, it's basically a matter of personal preference. So, I don't think there's anything you really wouldn't want to put in there. If it's a harder vegetable, like say a squash, like butternut squash, you may want to saute it a little bit before you put in there. I know with onions and celery, if you like to saute, people would do that. So proteins, we can talk about proteins, you know. My stuffing, I like the sausages, or pork sausage. You can use chicken sausage. You know, we're in New Orleans right now.
Seafood.
Seafood, it's a good thing. You know, when they had Thanksgiving, oysters is a great one to use. You know, when they talk about the first Thanksgiving being up in New England, they had a lot of oysters up there, so that was always a good thing to eat there. So, again, matter of personal preference, you can probably use anything you want.
What about chicken?
Chicken, if you want to shred chicken up or cut chicken chunks up, something like that. Even, you know, you like tacos, you go to taco meat if you wanted to, but you'd probably be the only one eating them, so. So something else you can use, you know, fruits and nuts. So, you know, you got things like cranberries are always a good ingredient. So, that's apples here that we sauteed. So there's another example. So, any kind of nuts, pecans. I mean, where we're at, we're in Louisiana. Pecans, great place to have them, so. You hear a lot of references. Chestnuts as well.
Christmas.
So we got that. And then the other thing you want to add is you want to add your different components. You have your herbs and spices. Another big thing in there. So you've got good old salt, pepper, sage, thyme, and rosemary are always good options. And you always have a good old poultry seasoning that you can put in there as well. So all right. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to make my sausage stuff. So what we're going to start off with. We're going to go ahead and use a whole bag of this, so this is saying it's 12 ounces. You want to make sure you get a big pot when you're making this stuff, that way you got a lot of room to work in. So basically, I've added 2 bags of that. Now, I have browned some sausage, and I've cooked some onions. Make sure that these are nice and cool, but we're also going to put an egg in here. So if you put an egg in here, and then you put these in there hot, what are we going to make?
Scrambled eggs.
Scrambled eggs, and we don't want scrambled eggs in our stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and break this in there. Now, I've got about a pound of sausage that I browned, and we're going to go ahead and use that. I got that in there. And this is just one onion that I sauteed with a little bit of butter. So we'll throw that in there as well. Alright. And then another component that I didn't mention earlier. Raw. You need to have a little raw to help bind it all together. So we'll throw a little bit in here. And now this is something you can always add more. You can't take it out. So you want to make sure that you're not done with the whole thing, and you want to add a little bit at a time. So I'm going to throw a little bit in there. Kind of get this going. So that's about half of a box in there. So I'm going to start getting this going. I always try to start off with a spoon, but there's just sometimes I can stick my hands in there and get it going. What we're looking for is like pie consistency. Did you ever make pie dough?
Mm-hmm.
You know how it's kind of squishy, but it kind of holds together?
Yeah.
So I don't think I'm even close to that. So you want to have a lot more raw for that. You know, if you use regular bread that's a little softer versus stuff that's in a bag, you know, you probably wouldn't have to add as much raw to that. But when you're using harder bread, you probably need to add more raw. So we'll keep adding a little bit more in there. So we're not going to stuff the bird. We're going to make this, is going to be dressing instead of stuffing today.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to make sure you add a little bit more liquid to it to keep it binding as well. So try to push it down a little bit. Try to combine it. So I learned this recipe from my mom, who learned it from her parents. So this one's kind of been passed down through some generations in my family. A lot better there. So, what they always told me, a rule of thumb, always have time. What you do, cover the top. So, be a little careful with that. That's usually how you can tell what you put in there. You cover the top from the top.
What season was that?
That was time. So, pretty simple stuffing. Tastes really good. So we're going to find out what we're on. Just tell me the taste. All right. So what do you think there? What do you want to combine? All right. So what we're going to do, make sure you take a casserole dish. You want to make sure you coat it with some cooking spray before you put it in there. What we're going to do is we're going to throw a little bit in here. And then what we're going to do next, so we're going to put this in the pan. We're going to push it down. Now, something you can do that a lot of people like to do now is kind of come up with a new trend is a lot of people like to have the crunchy parts. So what you can do is actually take one of those muffin tins and put it in a muffin tin so everybody has their own little muffins and then around the outside be all brown.
Oh, yeah. Enjoy.
What we're going to do is we're going to cover it now. Now, we're going to cover it because we want to do what? We want to keep all that juice in there. We don't want to evaporate it. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and cover it now. We're going to put it in the oven at 350 for about 45 minutes to an hour. That last 15 minutes, what we want to do is take the cover off and let it get a little crunchy on top. So I'm going to go ahead and cover it. Right. Walk over to the oven. Simple enough?
Yeah.
Very easy? Alright, guess that you can make your own?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what I did is I made you a list of some other ingredients that you could add to this. And then I want you guys to kind of look through that together as a group and pick out a few things that you'd like to add to it. We'll go ahead and make our own stuffing out of that. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'll just go ahead and circle a few things on there. Do you want to use bread? Do you want to go a different route, or do you want to stay with bread?
Cornbread.
Cornbread? So
yeah.
I got a little bit of cornbread left in there. Anything else? You want to add more bread to it?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So I want to stick with bread. No rice, no tofu, no quinoa. All right. Okay. All right. So when you talk about proteins, when are you looking at proteins? Do you want to go to something else besides sausage, or do you want to stick with sausage?
The simple sausage.
You want to stick with sausage? All right, well, we got some in there already, so we're good to go. Now, how about vegetables? You know, we got onion in there already. Is there anything else you want to add?
Celery.
Celery. All right. Well, we got a little sauteed celery over here you can add. Okay. A little bit of celery. up a little bit. Add a little bit of broth. Maybe that's enough?
Yeah.
No, probably a little bit more. Alright. You think I had an extra container, right? Now, what kind of broth do you think you're eating?
Chicken broth.
Chicken broth. Did you want to use beef broth for this?
Unsalted.
You could probably use vegetable broth, or you could, I wouldn't use seafood broth. Unless you make a mix or stuff. Alright, what's something that we added to the first pot that we haven't added to this one yet?
Seasonings.
Seasonings, alright. Anything else we forgot? Can you grab another egg out of the fridge, please?
Yeah.
Alright, so seasoning, what are we going to put in?
Salt, pepper.
Salt, pepper.
Thyme. Cover the top.
Yep.
Thyme.
Salt. There's salt. Thyme. Alright, I'm going to fill that you, sir. With this, you should. Alright, so, give me a little crayon, I'll put a little poultry seasoning in there, how does that sound? This is good for putting on turkeys. And then, here's a little bit of sage. There's sage actually in the, sausage, but this is really good. What do you think of that? Feel pretty good?
Yeah.
Alright. Alright. That's my egg. You want to stir that up a little bit? There, I'll hold the pot for you. Make sure you scramble that egg a little bit. Get in there, give me eggs. Get another one. How's it looking?
I'm not tasty enough.
How tasty enough?
I have a bowl here.
There, come on around. Let me see real quick. Let's see what we got.
Here's a little one.
What do we gotta do next? You want to make sure it's nice and smooth so you can even cook it. You got low spots, you might want to scoop a little bit before the
air
is done. You can add some more. Alright, so once she gets this all smoothed out, what do we need to do next?
Turn the oven.
What do we got to put on there first?
Oh.
Oil. Keratin, think you're doing okay?
Is it even?
About a quarter.
Are you used to do
that? Yeah.
Degrees. take a little break.